To go, Kesh Duren walks it forward. Kesh wearing a green cap. Mystery Island feels Danish, drawn toward the inside. Kulth stands well. Tenaku to his right. Krezy the last to move in. And so they're set. On a day at Ascot that will be long remembered. They're off and they're racing in the last, and Fields Danish from the inside sprung the stalls well. Groundbreaker out, Norman coming across and also driving forward, Tell Nothing. Constant Dreaming's going to kick up inside of Truly Reliable. Roch Legacy is right behind those, driving forward, Tenakutu. A length and a half away is Kulth. Down on the inside, he's a Parker, Mr. Fahrenheit. They're followed back on the rails by Mystery Island, going over to Beckett's Gate. And then came Krezy, and back last of all is Off We Go. Up along Matheson Road they head at the crossing. Our Norman took over for Watson, the replacement rider. She settled him in front from Tell Nothing. Over on the inside, running third, Groundbreaker. Constant Dreaming's up there in fourth spot. Fields Danish at Northerly Lodge is fifth, a half a length away, Tenakutu. Almost two lengths behind those next of all. Over on the outside, Roch Legacy going up in front of Heza Parker. They're a length clear of Kulth. Mystery Island next in the back half of the field. Further back, Truly Reliable, Mr. Fahrenheit being followed by Off We Go, and Krezy's the tail ender. They go to the 1100. Now they start the run down that searching Swan River side of the Ascot course with our Norman, the pacemaker. A half a length over Tell Nothing, a length and a half behind them to Groundbreaker, down on the inside of Constant Dreaming, is going up pretty well. A length and a half away then came Tenakutu. Fields Danish the rail. Now here goes Kulth. Kulth takes off around them here at the 800, followed forward by Truly Reliable. Mr. Fahrenheit pulled out four deep. Roch Legacy, though, got shunted right back in the field. He's a Parker, Krezy, followed by Mystery Island. And last of all is Off We Go. Homeward bound, 550 metres to run in the last. Our Norman from Tell Nothing going up. They've gone on equal terms. Two lengths behind them, Constant Dreaming, grinding away. Groundbreakers off the bit behind them. Kulth given a taste of the shillelagh. Tenaku to the middle, waiting for the run. Fields Danish, Tell Nothing. Our Norman together, stride for stride. Down the outside now, Constant Dreaming puts in its run. Mr. Fahrenheit's coming home. Tenakutu trying to bullock his way through as well as Mystery Island. Constant Dreaming had hit the front with 100 left to go. Mr. Fahrenheit, Mystery Island though will knock them all out. Mystery Island's won the last. Mystery Island beat Mr. Fahrenheit and Constant Dreaming. Our Norman close up, Roch Legacy unlucky. Krezy rattling home, Tenakutu, Fields Danish, followed then by Kulth. Off We Go, Truly Reliable, Groundbreaker. Further back, Heza Parker. And knocking right up on the turn to finish back their last is Tell Nothing. Mystery Island, Willie Pike gets a treble. He's timed it beautifully. Five, Mystery Island storming home. An emergency in the Perth Cup. What's to say he won't be here next week if they go? There's a lot to unpack. Beats Mr. Fahrenheit, Constant Dreaming, and it looked as though our Norman might have held on for fourth. The numbers are 5, 13, 8 and 6. Mystery Island has got the money, trained by Lindsay Smith. And in effect will be one of the last horses Lindsay trains out of WA, with his intention to close down his Albury stables, concentrating on his team in Victoria and Warrnambool. Mystery Island by Victor Pisa from Mystique for Limerick Lane, K. Bamford, Mrs. C. Bamford, written by Willie Pike, a treble for Pikey. And so often is the case, he wins the last. He's got there, beating 13. Mr. Fahrenheit by reward for effort from Lady Gwendolyn, Holly Taylor, Sean McGruddy. And Constant Dreaming, the Blackfriars mare from Aloha, Miss Adam Durant, Clint Johnston, Porter. Now, Roch Legacy got shuffled right back at a vital stage of the race and finished up getting clear and pelting to the line to finish on their heels. But again, Pike, he was back there too, but he worked his way through the congestion. And there was a fair bit in front of him as well. In fact, he'd come from behind Roch Legacy, who was grinding away, just didn't get a lot of room late. 36.84 the last 600, 217.13. But this was being trained for a Perth Cup. It was coming back into a 66 plus, and it looked $1 million. Okay, so it's a significant victory in the last as we take you down to Brittany and with Donna Reardon, who's been the long time stable representative and foreman here for Lindsay Smith in WA. And I guess it's a fitting result, the last event of the day, that Donna's there with you as Pike comes back aboard Mystery Island, maybe for the last time, a horse in the care of Lindsay Smith.
Well, that was the plan, that this would be Lindsay Smith's final runner here in Western Australia. However, with what's going on with the Perth Cup, we're expecting that perhaps it will be run next Saturday. And this horse was in the emergencies, which means he might be able to gain a start into the Perth Cup, Donna. It would be an extraordinary set of circumstances.
Oh, absolutely. It'd be an absolute dream if he could get a start in the Cup next week.
Obviously, this was meant to be Lindsay's last runner, and let's just say it is for the sake of this, but what a wonderful name he's had in racing here in the West.
Oh, absolutely. It's been an absolute pleasure to work for him and an absolute honour. He's been amazing. I've learnt so much. He's got the most beautiful setup down there, and the horses get looked after so well. They're so fit and healthy and happy, and that's why he wins so many races.
We should have known that Lindsay wouldn't be one to be going out on a low, that this horse would be winning today to be sent off on a high.
Absolutely, yes. And maybe if he runs next week, then obviously that'll be his last runner, maybe.
That would be a wonderful result. Congratulations here.
Thank you very much.
Here's Donna Reardon. Let's get over to William Pike.
William Pike, well, first and foremost, let's talk about the Perth Cup. That's something that we hope to never see again, but it's certainly a unique situation.
Yes, it is. Call it what you want to call it. For me, it definitely adds a bit of a curveball because I'm booked to be over in Queensland. So, jockeys, trainers, everyone, it throws a spanner in the works.
It's a somber mood straight after, but the mood changes when William Pike rides a winner in the last. And Mystery Island, he's been a really nice horse since coming to WA.
Yeah, he has. He's actually been very consistent. The plan was to sit in the first four and outstay them, but I missed the kick and we had to go to plan B.
And it wasn't a bad plan B. He seemed to relish it.
He did. Possibly could have learnt something there. I don't know. I'll be watching from Queensland.
Let's say he did make the cup field for next week. 2,400 metres, how would he see it out?
Oh, he'll see it out, no worries at all. For the connections and everyone involved, I hope he does gain a run because probably deserves his spot in the field in front of some of the others, in my personal opinion.
Good luck on the week next weekend in Queensland.
Yeah, thank you.
There is William Pike. He wins the last here on Mystery Island. We'll wait and see whether it's Lindsay Smith's last runner here in the West, but if it is, what a wonderful innings he's had and been a mentor to so many in the start of the heavy sand training as well. Mystery Island takes out the last on Perth Cup Day, the first day of the new year.
Hit cruise control and rub my eyes. The last 3 days, and the rain was unstoppable. It was always cold, no sunshine. Some time. There's something.